Spoilers ahead. The movie begins with Eleanor Vance, also known as Nell, and her sister Jane disputing a house that their mother left Jane in her will, after Nell took care of her for the last 11 years. After receiving a 20-year-old car as a pity present, Nell demands her sister and her family to leave. Nell is in need of money and discovers in the local newspaper an ad for a study on insomnia at a Victorian manor house, so Nell agrees to participate. We cut to Dr. Marrow and Mary debating which volunteers to utilize for his study, which is essentially an experiment on how individuals respond to terror. When Nell gets to Hill House, she asks the caretaker Mr. Dudley to let her in. She enters Hill House through the gates after arguing with him for a while, and lets herself in the front door. Nell is captivated by the mansion she sees, and wanders around before bumping into Mrs. Dudley, who shows her to her room. A little while later we meet Theo, who arrives to the mansion and shows herself to be very materialistic and shallow.
I'm supposed to be an artist.
After getting to know one another a little better, the two head downstairs to look around, and begin having fun when they find a room with a carousel and mirrors, a flooded hallway with books for stepping stones, and a pair of large stone doors, blessed to judge anyone who stands before them. Before bumping into new guest Luke, who has an attraction to Theo.
Hey Theo.
Dr. Marrow, along with his assistants Todd and Mary, arrive for dinner. They talk about their troubles with insomnia, get to know one another better, and discover what they will be doing over the next few days. Following dinner, Dr. Marrow takes his guests to a room where he shares the history of Hill House and how Hugh Crane built it for his wife while frantically trying to have children, all of which were stillborn. Mary continues the story by stating that she senses evil all around and that there is more to the tale. One of the piano strings snaps when she inspects it, cutting her and forcing her and Todd to leave. As everyone gets ready for bed, Dr. Marrow informs Luke of Hugh Crane's wife's suicide, in an effort to scare Luke. Luke occupies himself with a book and a candy dispenser upstairs, while Theo makes an attempt to get closer to Nell.
The world's missed you.
While Nell and Theo are in bed, Luke decides to explore and bumps into Dr. Marrow. Before the two go their own ways, Nell and Theo wake to an eerie banging on the walls, and Nell and Theo crouch in fear. Luke runs to investigate the screams even though he was not aware of any banging.
Every room's like four times as big as mine.
The next morning everyone tries to talk things out, but Dr. Marrow assures everyone the coldness and noises were all due to the old plumbing. The following night, while Nell is fast asleep, she is confronted by spectral entities that are visible through the bed linens. Luke confides in Nell that Dr. Marrow must be up to something, and that he will look into it while she fills out paperwork for Dr. Marrow. Soon after Luke leaving Nell alone, she continues to encounter the supernatural. As everyone rushes in to check what is wrong, Nell is worried about what is going on in the house. Dr. Marrow and Luke have a look around but don't find anything, except a booby trap. The big portrait of Hugh Crane had been stained with blood that reads "Welcome home, Eleanor." There is tension amongst the characters, as Nell is horrified by the writing and demands to know who wrote it.
Who wrote this?
However, no one comes up with a confession. The group quickly finds the green room, where they discover a big unsteady spiral staircase, a fountain with a sizable statue of Hugh Crane, as well as a statue of a woman surrounded by six children. Another night arrives and Nell is woken by another noise. Looking down, she discovers a path of bloody footprints that lead to a secret library. She discovers logs in the library of kids who Hugh Crane must have taken into his home, and learns that a large number of them had actually passed away while working for Hugh Crane. When Nell tells Theo, Theo doesn't believe her and returns to bed. Nell brushes her hair but it separates on its own, terrifying her even more. The following morning, Nell discovers Dr. Marrow's investigations, and discovers the true nature of the experiment. She also learns that he believes she is insane. Luke converses with Theo in the statue garden and appears to have deduced what Dr. Marrow was up to, but Nell says that it's not Dr. Marrow who is doing everything to the house, it's spirits. Hugh Crane's wife is hanging when Nell looks up, but no one else notices, prompting everyone to believe Eleanor is psychologically disturbed and ought to go home. In the library, Nell finds images of Hugh Crane's wife pleading with her to check the fireplace. Nell discovers a skeleton in the fireplace that comes to life, leading her to flee. While hearing children's voices asking for help, she attempts to enter a door but is punched by a hand that materializes from it, then dissipates. Eleanor informs the rest of the group that Hugh Crane recruited kids from the community to work in the mills, but never released them. Theo, Luke, and Dr. Marrow come to the conclusion that she is becoming insane, as a result of her emotional anguish. Theo finds out that they are taking part in an experiment to explore how people react to fear, and becomes enraged at what it's done to Nell. Feel. The moment Theo puts Nell to sleep, comforts her, and departs to get her tea, the walls take the form of a face and Crane chases her out of the room. Everything begins to crumble around her, chasing her through the house and into the carousel chamber. She then follows a spirit of a child to the green room. When Theo, Luke, and Dr. Mero finally locate Nell, she is ascending the spiral staircase. Dr. Mero rushes to save her, but the stairs begin to fall apart on him. But he gets Nell to safety. When Dr. Mero enters the green room to take notes, the statue of Hugh Crane grabs him and begins to spit blood. Theo, Luke, and Dr. Mero struggle to enter Eleanor's bedroom, as it encloses her in metal beams and reaches out to her. Once inside, everyone else is finally able to experience Hill House's paranormal together. They attempt to flee as soon as they have Nell out.
I'm not staying in this freak house another second!
But Hill House makes sure that there is no way out. When Nell realizes she needs to save the kids, she immediately runs back to the house. Everyone rushes in looking for Nell, and they eventually find her. Nell won't leave until she has saved the kids, despite Theo's best efforts to convince her. Being unable to leave the house, Dr. Mero, Luke, and Theo continue to look for a way out. While attempting to escape, Luke desecrates Hugh Crane's painting, so he is dragged into the fireplace and beheaded. Hugh Crane is now trying to kill the existing residents, as the house starts to come to life. Eleanor calls out Crane's ghost for the final battle, and leads him to the judgy doors. The doors come alive, and drag Hugh Crane to hell, with Nell getting caught between the two. She collapses to the ground, dying, and the children's spirits are released together with Nell's. The Dudleys return the next morning to let Theo and Dr. Mero out.
City people.
And the movie ends. The Haunting is a 1999 supernatural horror film directed by Jan de Bont, based on the 1959 novel The Haunting of Hill House by Shirley Jackson. The production company did not have the rights to remake the 1963 Robert Wise film. They weren't allowed to replicate even one shot from the film, and instead it is a whole new adaptation of the novel. The house used in the film is Harlaxton Manor, the University of Evansville study abroad center based in Grantham, England. Steven Spielberg was so disappointed by the final product that he removed his name, and ensured he received no credit. The novel being a big influence on Stephen King and his book The Shining, King wrote a draft of the movie, but after numerous changes took his name off it. Cortland Mead, who played Danny Torrance in The Shining, also provided voice work for the children. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more.
And you can't say anything because you actually swore me to secrecy.